Hi everyone, my name is Donnie Lowy at closeoutexplosion.com. Hope you're doing well today. Today I'd like to give you tips on buying wholesale through a Dhgate seller. Dhgate is a Chinese website that connects wholesale buyers with Chinese manufacturers, with Chinese wholesale suppliers, and Chinese distributors. So the first thing that you have to do is you have to realize that although there is buyer protection through Dhgate, the buyer protection basically entails whether it covers, whether your product is in good condition, whether it's damaged or not, and whether you get the product at all. So if you don't get the product, you're protected. If you get it and it's damaged, you have a chance to contact Dhgate and hopefully to rectify the situation. But always keep in mind that it might not be rectified in your favor. They might not rectify the situation. Hopefully the people at Dhgate are on top of their game and they will do it. But always have in mind when you buy something online, there is a risk involved. Now, I'm going to give you some tips that you should implement before you actually place your order. I actually was on SaleHoo on one of their forums, and I saw some of these tips, and they were great, and I believe everyone should utilize these tips. So tip number one, make sure that the product is actually new. You might assume that the product is new, and if you look at the product description, the product might not actually be new. So before you place your order, contact the seller. You know, it might be refurbished, it might be slightly used. You need to know that up front. If it is refurbished, find out if it's in brand new, you know, once it's refurbished, if it works like it's in brand new condition or not. If it is slightly used, find out, what does that mean? If it is out of the box, is it out of the box because it's new or just simply because it was returned by a customer? The manufacturer or distributor checked the product and the product functions as if it's new. You need to ask all these questions. Don't make any assumptions. You need to find out what the reality is. You also want to find out if there are any warranties. Are the warranties still in effect? Are they good? For how long are the warranties? If there are no warranties and you're getting a much lower price because there are no warranties, then you need to make sure to look at the feedback and see what do buyers say about those products. A product should have a warranty. That would be the best situation. But if a product doesn't have a warranty and the product is still good and the product has a very high rating, it's a very high quality product, and there have been no complaints regarding that product, then you can take a chance, or you might consider taking a chance. Primarily, you want to get a product that has a warranty, but if you find a product that's perfect for your customers that doesn't have a warranty, you really need to make sure that it's very good quality, and you need to make sure that the product, you know, is going to last. You also want to see what the feedback rating is. If the seller has a very high feedback rating, that can give you some assurances. If the seller does not have a high feedback rating, then you should think twice about buying from that seller. Another thing you should have in mind is that the feedback rating might not be very high, but that could be for many different reasons. Sometimes a seller has great products and is selling a lot of products, just might not have the best customer service. So the products can be great, but the customer service could be lacking. Also, when you're buying through Dhgate or you're buying through any website, make sure that the products are authentic. You know, sometimes you go look at the product and you could just get a good feeling by looking at the product, whether it's authentic or not. And sometimes you have to do some more research and ask yourself how that person has those products. If they're getting overstocked products from the manufacturer or overstocked products from the brand name, that's one thing. But if they are manufacturing products themselves and those products bear a license name or brand name or designer name, you need to make sure that that manufacturer has permission from the brand name or the designer to make products bearing their mark. All right, I hope you enjoy this video. My website is closeoutexplosion.com. The next time you are in New York, you are welcome to visit my warehouse. I am located in Brooklyn, New York. I'm very close to the Fashion District. I am in Brooklyn, which is very close. The part that I'm in is very close to Queens. I'm relatively close to New Jersey. I'm very close to Queens. I'm close to Long Island. I'd be very happy to do business with you. You can order online, you can visit my website, or you can send someone on your behalf and they can make a selection for you in the warehouse. Thank you so much for watching. Have an amazing day.